Hello, I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV at the 21st Annual Sonoma International Film Festival, and this is our filmmaker interview series. I'm here with lead actor and co-producer Mike McNamara, who has brought the short film The Replacement to the festival. In the year 2036, when cloning is commonplace, a janitor feels cheated after watching his clone become president. So we've seen lots of films where the children outstrip the father, but this is... this takes it to a whole much more personal level.
Yes, and it's such a great point. And this is really, as the film opens, so I play Abe Stagson, who, as what we would call an original, has agreed to be cloned. And at the time, he thinks, no big deal, I'll be cloned. Everyone's doing it. It's the new thing. And as the film opens, he is watching TV from his dead-end job on the midnight shift as a janitor, as his clone is being elected president. His clones have been elected to city council. They're becoming rock stars, TV stars, astronauts. They have taken off. And as the film opens, his clone has become president, and he is still sitting here working the midnight shift, pushing a mop, and he has had it. He has to take on the clones.
Yeah, because these are genetically identical to him.
Right, and yet they all become a little bit different. And really what the film takes a look at, it looks at many different topics, but there's a point in the film, and hopefully you'll all get to see it, where one of the clones of Abe says, can't you just be happy that you had this in you all along? Mm-hmm. And whenever I see that on the screen, it still strikes me, because you look at these different clones, and maybe we look at our own life and say, man, when I was 7 years old, I had gone this way instead of that way. What could I have become? And mm-hmm. That's exactly what all these clones are. They all go in these different paths, and some of them fail. But when you have 1,000 clones, right, a few of them are gonna strive ahead, and one of them becomes the president.
Right, so there's that kind of string theory element to it.
Right.
But there's also this nature versus nurture is what I was thinking about.
Sure.
You know, you take... cloning would allow us to see, you know, just actually how much this, because we love these movies, Trading Places and all of those things, but this would see when you take identical, genetic identicals, and you put them into these different settings, what the outcome is.
Absolutely, and it's really interesting. It just makes you think, and it makes you look at your own life and say, man, what if? And what if cloning continues to advance in our world today? You think there's some egotistical people running our politics and our governments and our finances and our courts now? What if you could? What if they had the ability to make their own clones and have kind of their own legacy for years and years, not by having kids and raising, just straight up just cloning yourself as much as you wanted to? It would be fascinating.
It's interesting because I could see it going both ways. I could see. Because the I think it's Ishiguro wrote that book Never Let Me Go, about and in that world, rich people can clone themselves, and essentially they're just organ donors, and they don't just sit like in a matrix like pod, because they found that in order for the organs to live well, they need to have these kind of normal life experiences. So in your world, the clones are actually outperforming the originals, as opposed to, I could see it another way, where the clones are just these slaves, essentially.
That's the other way you could do it. And maybe that's originally, I think it touches on it in our film, The Replacement, which hopefully you'll get to see it, 15-minute short film, and we're so thrilled to be here at Sonoma International with it. It's been amazing. The festival's so supportive, the filmmakers, we all love meeting each other, and the film goers are so supportive, but it touches on it in the film that maybe that's how this was originally intended. I think Abe originally is like, okay, I'm going to get these clones, and these clones are going to kind of have my back and take care of me a little bit. And
they'll
I'm going
to be pushing them off.
And... right, that's mm-hmm. right. And it kind of flips on them. And what I love about the script that our director Sean Miller wrote and that our producer Naz Khan brought to the screen with some incredible production value is that it really, it opens with a bang. As it opens, these clones it's out of control. And this kind of really pretty smart, relatively innocent plan that this janitor had to get his own clones has completely flown off the handle.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting because we're used to seeing films about clones where they look like Scarlett Johansson or Ryan Reynolds. And, you know, you're a handsome dude, but you look like a guy from Chicago.
That's right.
And
I'm
you
from Chicago.
Actually,
I don't know who Ishiguro is. I don't read. I'm just a film guy.
But you make yourself look schlubbier in the movie, and that's an interesting thing because that pushes against our. You know, we're looking at clones like Ryan Reynolds or what we would think most other films. Clones are these perfect-looking people.
For sure, and part of what you know, it's kind of the fun challenge as an actor. I'm playing all of these different roles, including this completely down on his luck janitor, and then at other times I'm playing a soldier, and then I'm playing this bartender, and I'm playing kind of a rock star, and then I'm also playing the president. So we had to kind of tweak that look, and Hallie Sharp and Sarah Sharp, who are on our production team, were in charge of that. And I think you'll really enjoy, when you get to see the film, seeing all of these different permutations. And for myself, there was a little bit of, okay, for this shot, I'm going to push out my gut a little more and change my posture a little bit. And then in the other times, you got to kind of tighten up and push your chest up. You know, and there's just these little things to really help differentiate these different clones. But so there, you can see how it's all come from the same guy, Abe Stagson, the original. It's originals versus the clones in this world. But at the same time, you want to differentiate, and you can see how they've all just become a little different and moved into different classes in the hierarchy.
Mm-hmm. And when you were in the process of this, did Orphan Black kind of blow up?
It's so interesting. That's such a great question, because we shot this film. The director, Sean Miller, and producer, Naz Khan, also a husband-wife team, so that's another fun thing about our film, they approached me in April of 2016. Mm-hmm. So we shot this film before Orphan Black, before Black Mirror, before there's another series with J.K. Simmons that's on Netflix or Amazon or one of those, called Counterpart, I think. And more than any of that, before the election, we shot this before Trump got elected. And so we sat there, and then we shoot this film in August of 2016, and then the unthinkable happens, and this whatever he is gets elected president, and we're all pretty devastated, but we also kind of looked at each other and said, well, our film just became a whole lot more relevant.
Well, and that's kind of, it's interesting that you raise that as well, because you know, I think back to Joe the Plumber, and essentially 4 years later, Joe the Plumber, everyone thought that was a great idea, and let's give this, I don't know how this man of the people, perceived man of the people, let's give him the biggest office in the country. But it is interesting about this, you know, talk about, you know, someone exceeding and getting to that loftiest height, and this idea that people feel comfortable. I mean, for me personally, I want a president who's a smarter, better person than I am. But for a lot of people, that whole have a beer with factor that first it came up with George W. Bush. Becomes that's the thing. I want a relatable president who isn't going to. And so you go from Obama to Trump that way.
Where is Trump relatable, though? Where is Trump relatable?
This is
what I don't get.
He's not relatable.
The guy was born into billions of dollars, and he's had billions of dollars his whole life. That's what I don't get. You know, just because he, you know, can kind of make small talk with some people and stuff, that doesn't make you relatable. Just because you put a button-down, you know, a flannel T-shirt on, which I don't think he's even done, you know, well, I've got this idea that he's relatable or that he's an outsider of the machine. I mean, he's been in the machine from the jump. So right. I don't see how I can see how George W. Bush is relatable. Right. Yeah. He's also much less intelligent than everybody else, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's a projection. People are projecting themselves. They're tired. They hate being talked down to more than anything. That's what's interesting with your film there, because here's a thing where, you know, so we have a person in the White House now who's a projection of, not myself, but for a lot of people, that's their guy. And what's interesting in your film is it's actually the same genetic guy that's in that office. But for him, it's the original Abe. It's horrible.
Yeah, it's. I really think this will be such a thought-provoking film for people to see, our film, The Replacement, because it really just takes you into this other world. You're transported into this other world, but you can see it happening. You can see yourself in that world. You're faced with those questions. What if I was given this opportunity? What if my clone went on to become president? Would I celebrate it? Would I? Because you'll see, original Abe is held in high regard by the other clones because to some extent he's kind of the godfather of the movement. This is the first clone to, you know, go on and become president. So original Abe is highly regarded in some way. But then when he steps back and says, hang on a second, what's going on here? I'm getting swindled here. You promised me this and you've all turned your back on me, which I think a lot of us can relate to today with mm-hmm. the president that we have in the White House. That's when everything hits the fan and everything really falls apart. And original Abe might have bitten off more than he can chew in this film, or maybe the clones have bitten off more than they can chew. So everyone's going to go head to head, and it's we really pack a lot into these 15 minutes, and I'm excited for everyone to see it.
Great. The film is called The Replacement. Lead actor and co-producer Mike McNamara, thanks a lot for coming and talking to us today.
Thanks
I'm
so much.
Rick Love for Sonoma TV at the 21st Annual Sonoma International Film Festival here on Sonoma TV.